But it's like, why am I going crazy? It's like, well, I think there's a collective things. Maybe I'm not going crazy, but it just feels like the glitch is in the matrix. Things are fucking upside down. And I'm just trying to hold on to reality. Grasp onto it. Like a cold beer in my hand. Cold Coors Light in my fucking hand. I want to get into some fucking disorders and syndromes. Because I feel like, and I'm just going to talk from my own personal experience. I was like looking it up while I'm working one day. And I'm like, what is that fucking thing where, what is that syndrome where you feel like everyone else is a robot? What is that syndrome when you feel like everybody else is a robot? And I found something, not really exactly, because I don't have, it's like imposter syndrome where you feel, imposter syndrome is like where you, you feel like you're not supposed to be, and this is like a simulation in some regards. But what I found is, I don't know how to say this either, Capgras syndrome or Capgras syndrome. I think it's the former. So basically Capgras syndrome, I'm sorry if I'm saying this wrong and you're like a psychologist and you're like, why are you fucking saying it like that? Capgras syndrome is a psychological condition. It is also known as imposter syndrome or Capgras delusion. People who experience this syndrome will have an irrational belief someone they know or recognize has been replaced by an imposter. Oh no! Oh no! They may, for example, accuse a spouse of being an imposter. You fucking bitch, where's Tiffany? What did you do with Tiffany? She was due 12 hours ago to suck these balls. You know, it can be upsetting for both the person experiencing the delusion and the person who is accused of being an imposter. You know, I don't ever want to be accused of being an imposter. I feel like I'm uniquely me. And it would be sad if somebody was like, where the fuck's Mike? Where the fuck is Whiskey Mike? And I'd be like, I'm right here, dude. And he'd be like, no, the other Whiskey Mike. And you're like, huh? It'd be upsetting, I could say. And I'd just be like, shut up, Timothy. You fucking idiot. Now go make me some goddamn nachos. You know, in some cases, the person experiencing the delusion maybe believe an animal, an object, or even a home is an imposter. Capgras syndrome can affect anyone, but is more common in women, of course. In rare cases, it can also affect children. I got to say this. I've never heard of this before. I started thinking about it, like researching who's the fucking robot. Now, I don't have anything about what the robot syndrome is. I looked it up. I can't find anything. Maybe I'm the first. They call it the fucking, you know, the Whiskey Mike syndrome. Like, it's kind of weird. There's only one person that suffers from it. And then that person's like, well, I feel that way too. And it's like, well, now there's two. That's my doctor's diagnosis on WebMD. you know, it can be caused by brain injuries, schizophrenia. You know, especially paranoid hallucinatory schizophrenia. You know, it causes episodes of Capgras syndrome. Schizophrenia also affects one's senses of reality and can cause delusions. Yeah, so there's that. I still don't think it bangs in the fucking booty hole of what you feel like everybody's robots. Or maybe it's just that you're in a simulation. I don't know. I'm not just saying that because fucking people say that. I'm just, you know. You know, I've got some, I'm by myself a lot, you know. Like, I'm working. I'm fucking, you know, I'm in the beat laboratory making all the fucking moves, cashing checks, breaking necks. And I get a little lonely from time to time. So if you are like me, where you're a lonely individual, which I'm not really. I entertain myself by doing podcasts and talking to myself in fucking rooms. Loneliness can lead to various psychiatric disorders like depression, alcohol, abuse. That's probably it. I'm probably just lonely. I need to fucking get out of the house. This fucking coronavirus isolation bullshit has really given me done a number on me. Oh, that's bad. Child abuse. No. Sleep problems, personality disorder, and Alzheimer's disease. I'm not old enough. I don't feel it to get Alzheimer's, but I feel like it's coming. if I'm already at this stage. I got loneliness, I guess. I'm not really lonely. I got my son and you know, I see my friends, so I'm not really lonely. In fact, I think I told you already, I fucking hate being around people. You know, my friends are great, but I hate even being around them. You know, sorry, guys. It's the truth. You know, I don't have depression. I'm not depressed. But I do, maybe alcohol abuse. But I don't go overboard. I'm not like, you know, I have an episode where I talk about it. I'm like, I drink 6 to 8 beers a night. But, I drink a little bit to ease the tension of my life. No child abuse. Sleep problems, for sure. And the sleep problem is that I sleep too much. Some are like, that seems great. No, it's not. I'll tell you why it's fucking not. I will go to bed, and it doesn't matter. I could go to bed at fucking 6 p.m., and I'll wake up at fucking 8 p.m., and it will get 14 hours of sleep. And I've already gone, you know, they say there's 4 stages of sleep, like you're in deep REM sleep. I'll go past that shit. I'll go in MER sleep backwards, and I wake up like a fucking question mark. My back feels like it's in my front. My front feels like it's in my fucking back. Things are not right. Realities are upside down, and I'm hurting. You know, it's like I've been sleeping in a gosh darn vehicle in the front seat, and I'm too late. I'm too fucking tired to prop the seat back, like hitting the fucking little louver. And I'm just sitting straight up all night. And then I try to curl up. And I'm sort of a big person. You know, I'm over 200 pounds. And I'm like sitting there taking up all the space in my fucking hatchback with my stick shift riding up my fucking inner thigh. Oh, that's how I wake up. You know, no matter when I go to sleep, I get fucking 14 hours of sleep. It sucks. And I wake up painful. So I do have a sleep disorder. I mean, people say you need a lot of sleep. You got to get a lot of sleep. You out into the woods, you out camping or some shit, you'll sleep for fucking days. You know what I mean? Like, you go out there and you'll just sleep for fucking ever. Go to sleep at like 6 p.m. when it starts to get a little bit dark in the near the fall, and then you're up at like 6. You're like, where did time go? I was asleep for half a fucking day. Rip Van Winkle up in this motherfucker. Some call me Rip Van Stinkle. You know what I'm saying? So there's that. Isolation. Does isolation cause mental illness? Isolation and health and mortality. Let's read a little bit more, shall we? I'm just reading off the Google. I'm not even going into Wikipedia. Social isolation has been found to be associated with poor mental health, including increased risk for depression, cognitive decline, anxiety, and substance use. Social isolation in elderly individuals is also associated with an increased risk for dementia. Yeah. You know, your brain, human beings have these brains that just fucking run wild if you don't reel it back. The brain is an amazing fucking thing.